Hello, welcome to the channel and welcome back to Resurrect Autos HQ. Today, guys, we have got Alan's camper van back in for some more paintwork. I'll explain what is going on and where we need to do. So in a bit, I'll bring it in and I'll walk around it quickly and show you. Before we do, guys, just, yeah, incredible about that Citroen Berlingo. It's sold already for the Rex to Riches. We're looking for the next project, car 7 or van 7, who knows. I'm probably going to stay away from the van for a minute. Let's just go back to cars. Let's see what I can find. So, yeah, I've been looking at a couple of nice ones this week. Hopefully, they don't go up stupid price. People seem to sort of overbid, or they sort of, they pre-bid. And they bid up the cars before they even go to auction, which is crazy. I know some people, like, they haven't got time like I have during the day, sitting there watching the auctions and watching the cars go through on the auction, and they just go, oh, that's all I'm prepared to pay. But you might slightly miss it. It might go over, or you know what I mean? You just don't know what's going to happen on the day. So, yeah. Anyway, hopefully I can win something, and it'll be... Because we've got the pot's getting bigger. We've got now got £6,222 to spend. £6,222 odd to spend on the next project. So we should be able to pick up a nice one. A newish car now. That's what I'm looking for. I'm going to start pushing up. But yeah, let's see if I can find, who knows, BMW, Audi. Let's just see if what I can find. And we'll go from there. So that's it. That's enough waffling. Let's bring the van in, the camper van. I'll have a quick walk around. I'll show you what's going on. We're going to get into it and we're going to crack straight on. So let's do this. So guys, here we go. We've got Alan's camper van back in the workshop. Basically he's happy with everything apart from one bit on this. He's happy with whatever was done on this side right across. You can see how, like, it gets really, really dirty, this side. Can you see it? And what happens is, obviously, the water's running down off this glass and then it just drips onto the side panel in itself, and it's creating all these lines going down. But it is just dirt, do you know what I mean? At least he can just clean it all off now and give it a clean. It is just dirt, but it just happens, doesn't it? But yeah, no, he's happy with the painting or the rest of the van. It's just one area that I pointed out, actually, on the last video that we've done on this van. I did point this out. I'm not surprised that he actually wants me to do this. So basically what's happened is you can see that there's a line going all the way, a wiggly line going all the way down. Now that's all original. It looks like that ain't dirt or grime. That's actually behind the lacquer. So it looks like someone's sort of covered it up or whatever before. So what's Alan's, you can see it's all over here as well. So it's all underneath, do you know what I mean? So what Alan's asked me, I did say to Alan, look, what we'd possibly be able to do is bring Steve, who does all the polishing, bring him in. He might be able to sort that out and get rid of it and polish it up. And Alan was like, nah, can we just paint the door? So I said, yeah, of course. If you want me to paint the door, I'll just, repaint the door. But we'll have to retake off the handle, all the panel on the inside, take off all the rubbers again. I don't know about this wing mirror. I might, if it's easy enough, I might take off this wing mirror as well. It's looking like just a couple of bolts, to be honest with you. And maybe an electric plug somewhere. There'll be an electric plug somewhere on this. Probably inside. We've got to take all this off anyway, so we might as well just try and take that wing mirror off. And then all we've got to do then is take this quarter glass out, just tape it all up, and then just repaint the whole door. So, yeah, that's what we're doing today. That's the plan. Alan just wants me to just paint the whole door. So that's what we're going to do, guys. Everything else, you know, he's looking absolutely fine on the van. So he did have a little bit of a problem with his battery as well. That sort of seemed to, I think it was the alternator. It turned out to be the alternator in the end. We sort of worked out that it was the alternator that was shot basically, because it's a camper van. Even though like he's got a separate leisure battery on this, even though it's a camper van, it's that alternator's working hard. Do you see what I'm saying? That battery. I don't think that's an original battery for the van that controls all the van side of it. The leisure side of it controls everything else. The battery van side of it controls the van side of it, if you know what I mean. So I don't think it's an original battery, and I think the alternator is working too hard. So Alan's had that changed and had a bigger alternator that can take the capacity of the batteries, I think. So that he's had that done. Yeah, he had some problems with that. He's probably watching this thinking, yeah, I did have some problems with that. I didn't want to drive it. But yeah, we're going to crack on and get this painting down now on the door. And then hopefully that's it. We're done. He can have his van back, all working and all looking a lot decent than what it is at the minute. But, you know, it is a bit of prep work. We've got to rub all the door back. We've got to prep it all up. We've got to tape it all up. So it's going to be a little bit of messing around, but I think it's worth it in the end. So let's set you up, guys, on the tripod. Let's get cracking. Let's do this. Thank you. Right, guys, let me just cut in there and just let you know what I've been doing. So, stripped it all back, took the mirror off, handle, the rubber around the window, and I managed to get this plastic cover off as well, trim. I did initially started to do it whilst it was on there, and I thought, you know what, if I can take it off without breaking, snapping anything, I think it'd be worth it. So, yeah, got it off okay, no problem at all. It just gives it a better finish then. Do you know what I mean? I could just put the plastic cover straight back over once I'm done. And yeah, so that's good. So what I've basically done, I'm starting to go back. I'm starting to get it down. I want to knock it down with the lacquer. And obviously, you know, you can see that it's all a bit flat and a bit plain. The shine is gone. And that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to knock it down so that it's getting rid of that shine, which is the lacquer. So I've gone over it with a bit of 180 grit, and then I'll go over it with a bit of a 320 grit, and then it should be ready to receive base coat. Everyone's got their own ways of doing it. Everyone's got their own ways of using certain sandpaper, but I've seen loads of videos, and they're saying knock it back with 180, then 320, and then you're good to go. Just don't take it past the actual primer. You can see, obviously, patches where I've just gone a little bit further because the paint was obviously not great there, and there's sort of a little bit of a stone chips and stuff like that. So I'm just trying to get all those back and then prep it. No filler is needed on this door, so that's really, really good. I haven't got to fill it and wait for that. So, yeah, I've done the 180. Let's go ahead and do the 320. Then we'll give it a clean down, and then we'll start taping it up. Ready to get the cover over, ready for the actual painting. So let's keep going. Let's do this. We'll be right back. So, guys, there we go. The door is ready. Apart from just another panel wipe, the door, it's ready to be painted. I've masked it all up. I've back masked the door now as well. I've learned how to back mask the door, and it prevents any sort of paint going in. So it's, again, it's just me. I know a lot of you guys were trying to explain it on with the comments, but it's very difficult to explain things like this with just comments. But I've been watching a few videos, and one guy in particular over in America really does lay it out really well, explains everything so good. Yeah, his channel is called Paint Society. So check that channel out, guys, because it's been great help to me, to be honest with you. Paint Society. It's only paint, don't overthink it. So, and he's right, it is just paint, don't overthink it. So, yeah, get a lot of tips from him. But yeah, it's ready, guys. Just a quick wipe over with the panel wipe, and then I'm going to go for it. First of all, though, I have put a sort of a sheet down on top of, a dust sheet over the top of that plastic shield, but it's still a little bit windy in here, a bit dust, like, not dusty, but just a bit windy. So what I'm going to do is I want to get the whole floor completely wet now. And then obviously I'll get this fan over here, and then I'll put it over here facing that way, so it pushes it, so it's pushing it out the doorway. I won't have the fan going whilst I'm painting, but when I'm finished painting every stage, I will turn the fan on quickly, and then it'll push it out. But I want to make sure that the floor is completely wet. That way, when I put the fan on, it won't push, you know, any sort of dust particles all over the new paint that I'm doing. So, yeah, that's the plan. I'm going to knock up some paint in a minute and get it ready for painting. So, yeah, let's crack on. Let's keep going. Let's do this. So, guys, I think I'm there. As you can see, I've wetted the whole floor up. I've checked the panel, wiped it all over. And we are good to go. I've mixed the paint. We are ready to put it into the gun. So we'll lay down some of this. And then see how it goes. Hopefully, no problems, all good. It's about 25 degrees at the minute outside. So it's not that hot. So it should be okay. It's quite a nice temperature, I think, to do some painting in. And yeah, we'll see how we go. So we're going to go all over the van, all over the door, all the way up, all the way around to this point. And then, yeah, just do like 3 coats of base coat and then 3 coats of lacquer, clear lacquer. The first coat is just going to be a mist, quite a small layer. And then we're going to sort of gradually build up the thickness of the paint. So I don't want no runs in this paint, you know what I mean? I'm going to try and get this best I can for him. And yeah, let's continue doing the way I'm doing it. So far, so good. I've not had much problems with doing any painting like this, but then once you get into certain colours, metallics, it's just going to be an awkward. But that's another chat for another day. Guys, let's just crack on with this. Let's see how we get on. I'll set you up. Let's start laying some paint down. So, yeah, let's do this. We'll be right back. Right, there we go, guys. That is the base coat all laid down and ready to receive some clear. Done three coats, a nice mist coat and then two nice thick coats to go over the top of it, and it's come out really, really well. So super happy with that, guys. So let's lay down some lacquer, some clear, and yeah, we'll gradually build that up as well. Get a nice consistency, nice thick lacquer, and then it'll be ready to buff up tomorrow morning. So let's continue. Let's do some lacquer. Let's do this. Right, guys, there we go. We are all lacquered up, and yeah, do you know what? It's looking all right. It's, you know, it's laying a little bit flatter than normal. Like, you can see, like, it's got, you know, a little bit of orange peel going on, but I was expecting that anyway, really, let's be honest, you know. But it's not bad, it's not bad. So I've had one light coat and then three quite thick coats, really. I'm just trying to lay it on so it looks, you know, it's a lot better. So we're going to have a bit of work to do when it comes to flattening and polishing this door. But, you know, I was expecting to do that anyway, really. it does take a long time to master, knowing the temperature, knowing how to lay it down, how to deal with it. Paint is just a tricky thing to do. But I know that, you know, we all know that. So it just is what it is. But it's looking all right. It's looking good. I'm impressed with it. So I'm going to leave it like that. And then we'll come back in the morning. And then we're going to have a look at that and finish it all off. But for today, that is going to be the end of today's video, guys. And we will have a look at it tomorrow, take it all off, and then we've got to work on, I've got another car coming in tomorrow, Fiesta, that's needed some work, so that's coming in, we're going to be doing that as well. So, but for this afternoon, I am going to be taking the Citroen Berlingo, I'm going to deliver it to the new owner, and he's going to pay me for delivery as well. So, yeah, there we go. Right, okay, that's going to be the end of today's video. We have done the door. We'll come back tomorrow and see how it goes. Thanks for watching, guys. See you on the next one. See you soon.